Betting more on the Surrey Shoebox over the next couple of weeks. It's 25 minutes past 8 o'clock.
Some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, that grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. Aye.
All together now.
Always look on the bright side of life.
Tickets go on sale for the Monty Python live show. Are going to be held at the O2 Arena in London in July next year. The surviving members, John Cleese, Eric Idle, Terry Gilliam, Terry Jones and Michael Palin, so getting back together, of course, revealed last week. John Wood is from East Grinstead. Hello, John. Good morning.
Hi, Ben.
How are you?
I'm just fine, thanks. How are you doing?
Yeah, very good. Now, you won the British Film Institute's competition last year to find the world's biggest Monty Python fan.
I did.
What a great achievement.
Yeah, I was chuffed.
Now, do you think it's fair that anyone who knows you would say that you're a bit of a Monty Python nut?
They know that from the moment they meet me, usually. No, it's not that bad, but most people know me as a major Python fan, yes. I do talk about it a lot.
When did you fall in love with them?
When I was 13, I was at boarding school, and Python was on TV, but in the TV room, it was so packed, I couldn't see it or hear it. But one of my friends had one of the albums, I think it was another Monty Python record. People don't actually know the albums, well, many people don't know they exist. They're wonderful. I really recommend you. Do you know the album?
I've got one of them down in the garage somewhere, actually, at home, but on vinyl, but it's years old.
They're
years
all amazing. They're all fantastic. In some cases, better than the TV shows, even. And we used to listen to it in the study and lift needle up and savour every sentence. And that's how my devotion began in 73, which is 40 years, Cass.
So you know that these tickets go on sale today. You're desperate to go, no doubt.
Oh, yeah, can't wait.
Have you got a favourite Python?
Well, my favourite movie of all time is Brazil, Terry Gilliam's Brazil.
Right, why?
It's just, that's very difficult question to answer. It's just incredible. If you haven't seen it, it's difficult to explain, but it's just an amazing movie. It's a major chapter of my life, even. I've met half the cast, visited all the locations, even bumped into Terry Gilliam himself by coincidence and took him to lunch. Can you believe it? Bumped into quite a few members of the cast by coincidence, actually, which is really spooky.
Until they've now got those restraining orders on you, John, you know how it is.
No, honestly, I just bumped into them by weird coincidence. And so he has a special place in my heart, obviously. So he's a wonderful chap, an incredible artist. And he wrote in the book for me, he said, thanks for your devotion, it's made it all worthwhile.
Which is a lovely thing to say. Now, I heard them beautifully described last week as the Beatles of comedy. Would you agree with that?
Absolutely. Yeah, there is something magical about when they came together and the material that they produced back in the 60s, early 70s. It is special. They had no idea. They were just graduates mucking about. They didn't realise they were going to change the face of comedy forever.
What was interesting is a cynical friend of mine was talking about Little Britain. He said, well, when I look at Little Britain and I look at Monty Python, I think, well, Monty Python did new sketches every week. Whereas, you know, the modern sketch show, in many ways, is the same characters doing the same thing, just in a different, you know, location almost.
Yeah, and also I feel sorry for comedians that came after Python, because almost anything anyone does, somebody says, oh, that's a bit of a Python influence, really. They got that idea from Python, so they can't really do anything, because they were so revolutionary in all their ideas. And even now, it's timeless. I look at some sketches from the 60s, and it seems so fresh. From 69.
That's great. So, are you, going to be bashing the phone this morning, or have you got some kind of secret access to getting tickets ahead of the game?
Well, I'm waiting for my VIP backstage pass, obviously. No, but it's my birthday soon, so I've made major hints to the family that an ideal present at 10 a.m. they could start going online and getting ready to the moment when the ticket is available.
Right, and as you were named British Film Institute's world's biggest Monty Python fan, did you get a prize for that?
Yes, I got two free tickets to the premiere of the autobiography of Graham Chapman. It was called A Liar's Autobiography. And even better than that, I got chatting at the premiere to the film distribution company, who then gave me a 3-month contract to promote the movie on Twitter, because that's what I do for a living. I'm a social media guru. I tweet and Facebook for other people. They outsource it to me. And I actually promoted that movie, a member of the Python team, for 3 months. Isn't that amazing?
That's fantastic. It's like you're getting closer and closer.
Yes. I'm working on a book as well, a transcript for the albums as well, an official Python book that will be coming out next Christmas.
Right, so before you go, favourite sketch of all time, if there was one that you would actually be able to watch forever and a day?
I think it's the Silly Job Interview, which definitely, or The Lion Tamer. They're both pretty much on a par.
You see, I asked for one and you gave me two, but that's not allowed, John. John, lovely talking to you. Good luck getting the tickets and great achievement. It's really great that they're back together as well. Monty Python, those tickets go on sale this morning. It is 8:31.